Hello, I'm Jomica, and today I am going to show you how to install the Minecraft Bedrock server software onto a Linux machine. If you want to learn how to do it, continue watching, or if you would just like to have a server without doing all the work, you can check out my website here at servers.jomica.co, and I will do all the hard work for you. Here, you can create an account, just hit join, there's email, password, username. Once you fill that out, you can just hit log in with your stuff, and then you are brought to a dashboard. Here you can see all the servers I have set up and kind of keep an eye on. If you just click add a server, you are presented with this screen. You just select the game you want. Right now we have Minecraft Bedrock, Java, Rust, and Valheim. All of those are set up to be managed by you through the website. We do run other games. 7 Days to Die is one of them. If there's other servers, like software that you kind of want to run, let me know and we can probably help you out with that. But yeah, for this, you would just hit Bedrock. If that's what you're looking for, 10 players, you could do month to month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months. Each one, you get a little bit more of a discount. So you do month to month, it's $4.99 a month, and just click next step. It'll bring you to PayPal and everything will be set up. Click pay and then your server's up and running, ready to use. Super simple. So that is there if you want to do it. Otherwise, if you'd like to learn how to do it and install it yourself, let's get into that right now. So one of the first things we want to do is go and find the Minecraft Bedrock software. What I do is I search Minecraft Bedrock software or Minecraft Bedrock server, and you're brought to this page here. We are going to need this link here in order to install the server, but first what we want to do is open up PuTTY on Windows. If you're on Mac or Linux, you should have some sort of terminal that you can use, and we are going to connect to my local server. So put in the password and we are here. So I'm going to make this a little bigger. May have to zoom in later so you guys can read it. But what we're going to be doing is creating a new user and getting that all set up so we can go ahead and download the server software and get that installed. And to add the user, we are going to do sudo, if I can type, sudo add user, and we're going to go with the user MC server. I can do that. We need to enter the password for our current user, and that'll go ahead and go through. We are going to create a password that can be anything you want. Try to keep it secure just so you are safe, and we're just going to hit enter all the way through. And yes, that information is correct. We have no name, room number, work number, home phone number, all that stuff. We don't need it. After that, we can go ahead and go here, just cd/home list. And this is our newly created user here, MC server. So let's go ahead and go into that directory. We can look, nothing in there. And from here, I think we should be able to do everything from inside this user. So if we go in here, su-mc server, and is that the user's password? I think it is. Yes. So you want to put in the user's password there and not your current user's password. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to do a wget, and that is going to get us, that's going to download from a URL, and that's where we go ahead and grab this URL. Go ahead and hit agree, and then right click, copy link. You could probably do it without, but just go ahead and agree anyways. Make sure you read that and agree and all that fun stuff. And then we'll just go ahead and right click to paste in. That is going to download the file we need, and that is a zip file. So if we do an ls, we can see that it is actually here. The next thing we're going to want to do is unzip. So we can go ahead and do that. It's going to unzip the files, and we are just about there. We have all the files in place. This is all the files needed to run a Bedrock server. And yeah, next thing we need to do is we'll go ahead and edit the server properties, because that is a very important thing. This is where you set up your game on how you want it to be played. You can, you cannot adjust the window size after you go in with Nano. So yeah, server name, you can change that. We're just gonna change that to Jomica's test server. We're gonna keep it on survival. Forced game mode, we'll keep that false. Difficulty, I always like to play on hard. You get better items from mobs that way. Allow cheats, we'll keep that off. You can change the max players. Be aware that if you change it to like 100 and you get 100 people connected, you are probably not going to have a good time. So keep that to something that your machine can handle. Online mode needs to be true. Whitelist, I would suggest turning that on and keeping it on and adding people to the whitelist, because anyone can get on without a whitelist. Server port, we are going to keep this as the default. I don't think there's anything running on this server right now. The only time you really need to change the port is if you have multiple servers running on the same computer. What else? You don't need to change port V6. View distance, you can keep that as is. Tick distance, that's default. Player idle timeout, you can change that if you want. And yeah, same with everything else. Level name, that'll create the folder where the file is saved. Level seed, if you want to put in your own custom seed, that's where it would go. So if you have a seed, something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that's where you would put that number, and it'll pick that seed there. So the rest is, if you kind of know what you're doing, you can go ahead and change that. So Control X, Y to save, go ahead and hit enter. That is saved. So at this point, we can go ahead and start the server. To start the server, you're going to do a ./, and it's going to be Bedrock server. But if we did it that way, you would have to keep open this terminal. If the terminal crashed, or you closed it, or you lost power on your computer, your server would shut down. So what we want to do is use tmux. That is going to create a window that's going to stay open even after you close everything. And then we will run the Bedrock server that way. Go ahead and hit enter. And as we can see, it is starting up, and server is started. So now we have a server that we can go ahead and try to connect to, and we'll see what it looks like. So we can go ahead, open up Minecraft, wait for it to load. And once it loads, I should have the server information already in there, but we'll go ahead and take a look. We'll go ahead and hit play, servers, and what we want to do, go to the bottom, hit add server, and it should bring up the same page as this. So if we come in here, you could put anything you want in here. This is just your server name on your server list. Server address will be the IP address of your machine. This is my local machine at home, so I'm connecting using a local address, and the port number is the default port. So you can hit save. Actually, the port number is the one that you set inside the server properties. If you change that, you want to make sure you use the same one here. But this is the default here. So hit save. The name will show up down here. This is what you named the server, but we can go ahead, join server. I have one ping because it's very close to me. So we'll go ahead and hit connect, and we are in a world. At this point, I can go ahead and send the IP address, my external IP address, to my friends, and they can connect, and we are good to go. Another thing to be aware of is if you are doing it on your home network, you want to make sure you open up the port to the outside world But that gets into a whole other list of things to be aware of. So make sure you research that before you do it. Once you're in, a couple things you may want to do is make yourself an OP. So you can see here, this is the console where people joining and leaving show up. On Bedrock, chat and people who are killed and all that do not show up in the console. But you can run all the commands from here, no problem. So I want to make myself an operator. Go ahead and hit OP, Jomica 8281, hit enter. That is a command. Let me try that again. I think it is because I hit enter in here, and yeah, there we go. So as you can see, it added the little king crown symbol, whatever, and it, I guess it doesn't show up in chat here, but I am OP. Now I can go ahead and do the commands in here, whitelist, add, Jomica 8281, chat, cheats aren't enabled. Okay, so that's right. If you kept the cheats off, you're not going to be able to do whitelist stuff from in-game. You got to do all of it from in here. So we don't have the whitelist actually on, but you can add to it this way. And then player added to whitelist, and then you can go ahead and go to server properties, change it to whitelist only, and you are set up that way. And from here, you can either hit the X, it'll give you a little warning, but I like to do Control B, D, that will exit you out from your little terminal there, and it'll still be running in the background. As you can see, I am running. I can still run around, break things. And if we are in here, hit top or type top, you can see that the MC server is running. It is the Bedrock server. You can see how much CPU it's using, how much memory, all that fun stuff. And to exit out of there, just hit Q. It'll bring you back to the regular command line. If you are in this area and you want to get back to the console, just go ahead and type tmux A, and that'll attach to your last little window, which should be your server. And then again, just hit Control B and then D. That'll exit you out. And from here, we can just go ahead and hit exit because we are all done. That'll log you out of MC server. And then to close this out completely, just hit exit again. And we are done. So again, if this is something that you don't want to do yourself and you want me to do it for you, be sure to check out my website, servers.jomica.co. I'd be happy to set it up for you, keep everything running, have you and your friends connect any time of the day. It's always running, always working. If there's any problems, I am always available to get that set up and running for you. If you're new to the channel and want to see more Minecraft content, more server stuff, other games, be sure to hit that subscribe button. Thank you all for joining me, and I hope to see you all in my next video.